Tonight's headlines are brought to you in part by Coldwell Energy and McDonald's.
Good evening, Commonwealth, and thanks for watching the Channel 2 News. I'm Sally Lemus. Let's take a look at tonight's top stories. The governor urges the House to amend their budget bill. Also tonight, the anonymized neighboring island gets their very first case of monkeypox. And gubernatorial candidates to go head-to-head soon in debate. In sports, kids up and early on a Saturday for a school event. Stay with us, we have these stories and more next.
Need a new phone? Trade in now and get up to $500 off our best 5G devices. Trade in your older phone in any condition and step up to better savings and speeds only our 5G network can provide. Check out our website and catch up on the best mobile experience. Trade in now. Docomo Pacific, better together.
We've made a lot of breakfasts, and along the way, we noticed something was missing. A warm cinnamon roll for breakfast, or with breakfast. A fluffy blueberry muffin from the drive-thru you're already driving through. A glazed apple fritter which might find its way into your coffee. These are options every breakfast haver should have, and now they do. Meet the new bakery sweets at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
To the Wami and good evening, Commonwealth. Today is Monday, September 12, 2022. With just days before the budget submission deadline, Governor Torres expresses disappointment towards the slashed appropriations for government agencies.
The Torres administration describes the House of Representatives budget bill as unconstitutional, illegal, and inappropriate. Governor Ralph Torres, for his part, says he is disappointed, as not only were appropriations for government agencies reduced, but the House increased their budget.
They increased their House appropriation. They increased by $1.2 million. So imagine they go around and they talk about the lack of funding, lack of manpower at DOC. And they make an issue about it. They make an issue about Medicaid. Oh, there's not enough funding. What's the governor doing? But yet on the very budget that they passed, the first thing they did is increased their House members by $1.2 million.
The governor says several agencies were reduced by thousands of dollars.
They went and reduced the Carolinians office by $94,000. They reduced the Indigenous Affairs office, $89,000. Veterans Affairs. We're here advocating to protect our veterans, thank them for all their services, the families. And yet they took $165,000 from their budget. Women's Affairs, $79,000. The OVR, $103,000. These are services that is very much needed to those folks.
According to the governor, the House majority also decreased personnel funding for the Department of Corrections, Department of Fire and Emergency Medical Services, and the CNMI Scholarship Office. Appropriations for CHCC and NMC were slashed as well.
You know, all of these things, that that they've done, it hampers the ability, again, to the whole operation. We have to hold now on renewing contracts because of this action. It's not the final, obviously, but it does set an alarm on the House majority on their ability to go ahead and pass a budget, knowing the fact that they violated so many regulations and actions. And that's why it's important for me to have legal counsel and Dave, Secretary of Finance, address that. And I plead the Senate to continue to do the right things.
The Senate will meet this Wednesday at 2 p.m. to discuss their version of the budget bill. House Ways and Means Chairman Donna Magnonia has not provided a comment as of press time. The legislature must submit a balanced budget proposal to the governor before October 1st to avoid a government shutdown.
While Guam confirms their first case of monkeypox, NMI health officials remain alert of the situation.
According to Guam's Office of the Governor and the Department of Public Health and Social Services, the first case of monkeypox is confirmed for the island of Guam. The case was imported by an incoming traveler who arrived on Guam on September 10. The origin of the flight is not confirmed. CDC was able to confirm the illness the very next day, Sunday, September 11. The traveler is cooperative and remains in isolation. The individual says they do not need medical attention and is being monitored for any changes in their condition. Isolation period will be confirmed as soon as they calculate the onset date of symptoms. Guam Health officials has also launched a case investigation to indicate any possible close contacts. According to Hospital Chief Esther Munia, quote, the CHCC remains alert and is actively monitoring the situation in the NMI. There are no current suspected cases of monkeypox, unquote. Munia further states that those who have an active rash or other symptoms must isolate at home away from people or pets you live with. You can confirm your diagnosis by calling the CHCC at 670-234-8950 before you visit. CHCC says no changes have been made for incoming travelers and the CNMI has monkeypox vaccines available. More can be ordered based on demand.
The general election is less than 2 months away. The Saipan Chamber of Commerce is sponsoring an event that will allow voters to get to know their candidates a little bit more.
The 2022 gubernatorial candidate debate is set for September 29 at the World Resort Saipan Taga Hall. This debate is hosted by the Saipan Chamber of Commerce.
The purpose and the goal for it is to provide the community the opportunity to hear from their future leaders on their plans and their goals for the people and for the island. So that's one of our main goals for this event. And I'm hoping that, you know, the candidates will be able to address any issues that our communities might have in concern.
Chamber Director Kimberly Camacho says the public can submit questions which may help in formulating the topics for the candidates. All three gubernatorial candidates are expected to be present.
So we have all three running governors confirm attendance for this debate. So it's going to be exciting, and I'm sure the public is excited as well.
Doors will be open to the public at 5 p.m. with the opening ceremony at 5:45 and then the debate from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Camacho says they are currently working towards making the event live.
We are working with Northern Marianas College right now to see if there's a way for us to have it live stream via Facebook. So it's in the works. I can say that we are going to live stream it, but the details of that is to come later at a later time.
This year's moderator will be Patricia Rodriguez under the Guam's K57 News. For those interested to attend or send in questions, you can visit the Saipan Chamber of Commerce Facebook page for the link.
I do encourage everybody to visit our social media platforms as well as our website, siphonchamber.com, to RSVP for the event. We have opened it to the public as of this morning at 8 a.m. And it's going really quickly. So those who would like to attend in person, I encourage you to get online now and do your RSVP. And I just like to note that we are only allowing 2 tickets per person for this RSVP, just to ensure that everybody has the opportunity to attend the event.
The Northern Marianas College will also be hosting a debate, which is targeted for next month.
KSPN has just been informed that the seats for the Siphon Chamber of Commerce gubernatorial debate is sold out. Now, speaking of debates, a local radio talk show named Marianas Agupa recently held their own virtual gubernatorial debate last August. Only 2 candidates, Tina Sablon and Arna Palacios, participated in the event. Governor Ralph Torres says he wasn't invited.
They never invited me. I was surprised that after the event, I was called and asked why didn't I participate. I said nobody called me. The radio station knows my number, and I would have be glad. I'll gladly join if they were to invite me to join. I've always been up to interviews and share the insights and the right information to our community.
The NMI's 3 educational institutions are set to deliver their very first State of Education address this month.
Leaders of the Northern Marianas College, Northern Marianas Technical Institute, and the CNMI Public School System will be delivering the State of Education Address on September 22 at the World Resort Saipan Taga Hall. The State of Education Address is an annual platform for NMC, NMTech, and PSS to gather and share their strategies for student success and workforce development to the community. This year's theme is Finding Our Way Together, which underscores the collective commitment of the 3 public educational institutions to face global and regional challenges. The SOEA will include NMC's President Galvin Delon Guerrero with NMTech CEO Jodina Atal and PSS Commissioner Alfred Atta.
All right, coming up, flu season is here and shots are encouraged. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the Channel 2 News. It is flu season in the CNMI, and healthcare workers are urging community members to get their shot.
The Commonwealth Healthcare Corporation urges all CNMI residents who are 6 months old and older to get their annual flu vaccines for this year's flu season. Pregnant women, children, elderly, and those with underlying conditions are highly encouraged. The flu is a potentially serious disease that can lead to hospitalization or even death in some rare cases. Every flu season is different and affects people in different ways. But CHCC says getting the annual flu vaccine is the best way to protect yourself and loved ones. You can request a flu shot during a clinic visit at the CHCC's Children, Women's, and Family Care Clinic and other private medical providers. Flu shots are also available by walk-ins to the CHCC Immunization Clinic located at the lower level of CHCC. Pregnant women, regardless of their trimester of pregnancy, are urged to receive the shot as well. People with severe, life-threatening allergies to gelatin, antibiotics, or other ingredients in a flu vaccine other than the egg proteins should not get the vaccine. People who have had severe allergic reaction to a dose of influenza vaccine also shouldn't get the vaccine. If you have any questions regarding the flu vaccinations, including where to get one, contact the CHCC Immunization Program at 670-236-8745.
The NMI Museum had its soft opening over the weekend, introducing Fiesta Fridays to the community. Here is a Sights and Sounds of the event.
This evening, you can see that this is the start of the Fiesta Friday event that we're going to be having regularly at the museum. It's supposed to be a soft opening, but we're really happy with the turnout right now. We're still seeing people come in, so you know we want to just tell those people that didn't come, our residents that didn't come, that next Friday they have the opportunity to come down to the museum to enjoy good food, great entertainment, and things for the kids to do.
All right, folks, don't go anywhere because we have sports up next.
Need a new phone? Trade in now and get up to $500 off our best 5G devices. Trade in your older phone in any condition and step up to better savings and speeds only our 5G network can provide. Check out our website and catch up on the best mobile experience. Trade in now. Docomo Pacific. Better together.
Saipan's beaches, this mother lays about 100 eggs under the cover of darkness. She hides her nest as best she can and then slowly makes her way back to the ocean. The eggs hatch and the babies head for the sea where they will face a daily dose of danger. Just 1 in 1,000 will make it to adulthood. Those that do will one day lay their own eggs. Sea turtles are protected under CNMI law. If you see one that is stranded or if you see illegal activity, call the hotline at 287-8537.
Tonight's sports brought to you in part by Tan Holdings through the Tan Soo Lim Foundation, making communities a better place to live.
Buenas sports fans.
Saipan Run will be hosting their second annual Intercontinental Coastal Cleanup on Saturday, September 17th at Tank Beach in Cagman. The race will start at 6 in the morning and then a beach cleanup to follow after the race. They will also have raffle prize giveaways after the cleanup. The race is free for Run Saipan members and non-members can pay a $5 fee to participate. Run Saipan President Edward De La Cruz is asking Cagman residents, especially dog owners, to secure their dogs as PSS will also be hosting a separate race in Cagman on the same day. Runners can register on raceroster.com. For more information, please visit the Run Saipan Facebook page. The second annual Intercontinental Coastal Cleanup is sponsored by Salty Skin Pacific. Saipan International School hosted its first cross-country race for this year.
Over 500 students from different schools in Saipan participated in the SIS first all-schools cross-country race on Saturday morning at Bonsai Cliff in Markey. In the elementary division, students ran 800 meters on the grass side of the road and then turned around and headed back to the finish line. Oh, Ohio middle school students did the same course, but twice. In the high school division, students ran a 5-kilometer distance. From Bonsai Cliff, runners will turn left on the main road past the last command post. Turnaround point is on the top of the hill, just past the turn towards Suicide Cliff. Here are the highlights from this event. SIS Headmaster Dr. Ron Snyder is very pleased with the turnout of the race.
We had a great turnout in the all-girls division. It's our first race of the year, so they're still learning, and the times are only going to get better. The open category, we had some top-notch runners out here doing some really great times, even though they were running it in some heat, and that hill up Suicide Cliff is brutal, so kudos to them for doing that. Every year, we change it up a little bit, gets better a little bit. We'll make sure the course is totally ribboned off next year so that it's a grassy exterior, no threat of traffic. I think it'll be great for the elementary and the middle school divisions for that.
This race is sanctioned by the Northern Marianas Athletics, the Commonwealth Coalition of Private School Sports Association, and the CNMI PSS Athletics Department.
Golfers, come north and practice your game at the Marianas Driving Range. New Year's local specials. 10-piece coupon books available for just $60. That's a $10 savings. Want to get really good? Come work on your swing every day for just $99 per month. It's our practice pass and you're going to love it. Grab your passes and go straight to the range. You can social distance and chip all at the same time and the views are free. Reserve now at marianastrekking.com. You can pay online, open 7 days a week.
Hi, I'm Dre, one of the personal trainers here at Goat's Gym, and today we're going to be going over the leg press. Now I have here with me is Vince, and he's going to show you how to execute it properly in two different ways. A common mistake that you'll often see is leaving your hands free, either up here or on your lap. I strongly recommend you holding onto the sled and create that tension in the upper body, which then allows you to create more range of motion. So with his current foot placement, he was feeling it on his legs, his quads. Now with a simple adjustment by placing his foot a little higher on the platform and his toes pointed out slightly, he's going to transfer that tension, which was previously on his legs, onto his hamstrings and glutes. Again, he's gonna grab onto the sled, creating that bracing effect up here.
For the K-Spin weather report, mostly sunny with isolated showers, southwest wind 11 to 14 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy with isolated showers, south wind 9 to 14 miles per hour. High 88, low 79, the humidity 79%. Tomorrow, mostly sunny with isolated showers, south-southwest winds 11 to 14 miles per hour. High 88, low 80, the marine forecast, combined seas of 3 to 5 feet. Today will persist through the week. Southwest winds 10 to 15 knots, wind waves 2 to 3 feet, east swell 3 feet. The sunrise will be at 6.05 a.m., high tide 9.12 p.m., low tide 3.10 p.m., and the sunset 6.21 p.m. All right, folks, there you have it. That is your Monday edition of the news, sports, and weather here in the Marianas. Thank you so much for watching. We hope you have a great night, and we'll see you back here on Wednesday.